But I remember on Sunday morning, no matter what happened, we had to be in church, Sunday school. We had to be in church. And we had an aunt named Annoni. You couldn't say a word in church. She was up there in the mother's den, but she knew you had chewing gum or even say a word, she'd come around with the fan. Now, you might not put that chewing gum in there. You might try to keep it. But she watching you like a hawk watching chicken. If you say a word, she'll come by and catch that ear. Put you on the, we call it the moaning bench. Because you're going to stay there and call on Jesus. So that was our anointing. She taught the Sunday school and everything. My father was one of the deacons in the church. His name was Harry Diggs. My father had a brother named Fred Diggs and Alfred Diggs. Because Lillie Mae's husband was named Dave. On Sunday morning, we didn't pay tithe in church. They come right to the members to get, you know, whatever they're going to give. So I had a uncle, Alfred. Everybody in the morning, a certain time, you could smell coffee a mile away. And they'd be cooking their bacon. And I had a uncle. They started from Lillie Mae house. Lillie Mae be up there cooking. Uncle Alfred, you want something to eat? No. That was his word all the time. But soon as you turn your back, bacon be in the frying pan or whatever, chicken, whatever be that. Okay, Alfred's going to get him something and put it in his pocket. And then he'll tell you, I got to go, let's go. So, Lillie Mae house was back there. Next house was in Nona. We stopped there to get Uncle Alfred.
I love you, Lord. For your mercy never fails me. All my days I've been held in your hand. From the moment that I wake up until I lay my head, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God. All my life you have been faithful, and all my life you have been so, so good. With every breath that I am able, oh, I will sing of the goodness of God.
'Cause Lillie Mae had Lester, Lula, and my mama had me and my two brothers. And we used to, when my mama working in Tabitha, all of us would come up to Sogner, get on Nana and on a porch, because Uncle Alfred had to tend to us. We asked Uncle Alfred, help us study our lesson. We didn't know Uncle Alpha couldn't really read until our mama, because my mama, you couldn't laugh at older people then. You couldn't pick at them. You got a good whooping. So we say, Uncle Alpha, what did this say? Uncle Alpha say, the dog say, babu, babu, this is my home. We say, Uncle Alpha, that don't sound like this. No, if you don't want to know, don't ask me. Study your lesson. So, okay. We asked Uncle Alpha how to spell hoppergrass. We was getting spelling that Friday. We had to turn in our spelling. Uncle Alpha, how do you spell hoppergrass? Don't bother me. That's what he would tell us sometimes to be out there in the field. Uncle Alpha, please, we got to study our lesson. We got to have that right in the morning. Okay, I'll come near. Sit down. All of us sit there in a hovel. Now what you wanna learn? See, I didn't spell holograph. Double whooper, double stop up, little SP pop. Okay, Alpha, what is that? He said, hey, you want to learn how to spell holograph? He said, yeah. He said, double whooper, double stop up, double SP pop.
Take me through the fire in darkest night. You are close like no other. I've known you as a father, I've known you as a friend, and I have lived in the goodness of God. Hey! 'Cause all my life you have been faithful. Oh yes you have. And all my
life. Uncle Fred, our uncle was something else. Uncle Fred, he would do things. We had a store we go to, was Crick Grub. Yeah, and Uncle Fred would go and tell Mr. Crick, if he ain't got no money, he wants some. But Crick Grub say, no, I can't give it to you, Fred. Long time ago, they had beans, they had rice. You had to dip it out. They didn't have it in a pan. So how much you want, they would dip it out and put it in a bag. So Uncle Fred told him, say, well, Crick, I want such and such a thing. He said, no, you can't get it. He said, I tell you what, if I don't get it, he said, I'm going to piss all in these beans and I'm going to make them fried up. Crick, Crick tell him, say, you better not do that. He said, I'm telling you, I want it. You can't do nothing with we dig. That's what he would say all the time. We dig, don't care. And the only way,
that makes sense.
Only way we do it, they would hear Uncle Fred don't do something, they go get my daddy. He would listen at my daddy. He used to get out there on 90 and stop traffic. The buses, anything. He would move out the way. We'd be over there in the church. My dad had to come out of the church, get him off the highway, because he would stop traffic. Now that's just the way my uncle was.
Your goodness is running.